Look, there is one way and one way only that I make mashed potatoes. And well, you know, this is it. I don't think mashed potatoes need an introduction, so I'm gonna spare you of that, but I do wanna talk about one thing, and that is the Humble Potato Ricer. Yes, if you don't know what this is one of the most beautiful devices ever created. Well, when it has to do with mashed potatoes. This is the secret weapon to making super fluffy, velvety mashed potatoes, period. Let's just make this. And, you know, I hope that you do too.
Okay, so forewarning, I'm sick again because my girlfriend got me sick again. So my voice might sound a little strange. Anyway, so you're going to start with 3 pounds of Yukon Gold potatoes. Make sure that they're Yukon Golds. You can switch up to starchier potatoes if you want to, but just be aware that potato starch content differs from potato to potato. Use the liquid that you make in this recipe cautiously. So obviously you got to peel the potato, but there's a little trick that I like to use. You're just going to take a piece of parchment paper and you're going to peel the potato over that. Then you just wrap it up and you got a nice little potato skin parcel for the trash can. And you're gonna cut those peeled potatoes into 1-inch by 1-inch pieces, or, you know, as relatively even as possible. You want them all to be relatively the same size so that they all finish cooking at the same time. Then as you're cutting those, you're just gonna place them in a cold pot of water. And be sure to pick an appropriately sized pot. Season the water aggressively with salt. You don't wanna make it too salty, but you do want it to be pretty freaking salty because that is going to help a lot in the final product. Plus, you can drain the water anyway, so don't worry about it. You wanna cook with the salt. Then just bring that up to a rapid boil over high heat and boil the potatoes for 15 to 20 minutes or until they're very fork tender, each and every one of them. Just be sure not to overcook them, otherwise they'll absorb too much water and the final product will be way too watery. Once those are done cooking, strain those through a colander and allow the potatoes to drain of their water. Now is the time that we're going to use the Humble Potato Ricer that I was talking about earlier. If you don't have one of these, I'll link the one that I have below in the description. You can get them at places like Bed Bath & Beyond. If you don't want to go through the hassle and get one, you don't have to. You can use a masher, but I really recommend this. This is kind of what makes this recipe, well, this recipe. Now, while your potatoes are still hot, you're going to press all of them through your potato ricer on the finest setting, assuming that it's adjustable, until you've mashed all of your potatoes. Now you've got this fluffy, mountainous terrain of pressed potatoes. Now this is your base. Now just place those to the side and keep them warm while we make our flavor liquid. This is the backbone to our base. Now I get it, this isn't a groundbreaking recipe, you know, butter, milk, heavy cream. Yeah, we all know that that goes into mashed potatoes, but this is the beauty of this version, is with this flavor liquid, you can build off of it however you want. So you're gonna start with 1/2 cup plus 2 tablespoons or 130 grams of unsalted butter. Begin melting that over medium low heat. Once that's halfway melted, you're gonna add 4 cloves of garlic left in their pod, just lightly crushed under your hand. You can see me grating it here. Yeah, don't do that. It's too much. Don't grate it into here. Just lightly crush a whole clove of garlic left in the skin and toss 4 of them in there and then just let them steep. Much more mild, much more delicate, less in your face. From there, add 1 cup or 300 milliliters of whole milk and 1/3 cup or 78 milliliters of heavy cream. Then just season it with salt, give it a little whisk, and at this point, you are ready to add any aromatic you want. You want to add bay leaves? Cool. You want to add thyme? Cool. Add some sprigs of thyme. Rosemary, sage, whatever you want in the flavor of this, you can toss in now, and then just bring it up to a steamy heat and let it steep for 10 minutes. And if you want some ideas for aromatics, there'll be some below in the description. Then just make sure to strain out any aromatics or solids you have in that liquid and add it to your pressed potatoes. Now, be careful when you're adding this liquid, because if you have a lower starch content potato, or your potatoes for some reason just aren't as absorbent, then, you know, just add it cautiously, little bit by little bit, until it comes together to the consistency that you want. Then just stir that bad boy together until everything is evenly incorporated, season it with salt and pepper to your liking, and you're done, dude. Serve that stuff with a fat pat of butter, some fresh cracked black pepper, and, that's mashed potatoes. It's not rocket science. And as you've all requested, the second B-roll sequence is back. Chove, chuva, chove sem parar. Chove, chuva, chove sem parar. Pois eu vou fazer uma prece. Deus. All right, guys, and that is it. Mashed potatoes simply done right with the potato ricer, because bless the potato ricer. I've got a lot of new video projects coming up for everybody, so, you know, please keep sending in your suggestions. I'm doing lots of fermented recipes coming up very soon.
So I hope you're excited. And I'm also looking to do more sourdough bread recipes. I keep getting DMs on Instagram and comments about people wanting more sourdough stuff. So it's coming, it's on its way. But in the meantime, if you enjoyed this video or you learned something, leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you next week.
Pra chuva parar de molhar o meu divino amor, que é muito lindo, é mais que o infinito, é puro e belo, inocente como a flor.